Hey, Jon from Supabase here, and today we're going to learn about combining server and client components in the Next.js app directory to subscribe to real-time events from Supabase. So basically, anytime a new record is inserted or updated in our database, our application automatically updates without needing to refresh. In the last video, we went deep on server components. So if this chunk of code doesn't make sense to you, I recommend you check that one out first and then come back to this one. But if you're ready to go, so am I, so let's get into it. We're going to start out with an existing Supabase project that has a single table for posts, and each post has an ID, a created at timestamp, and a title, and then our Next.js application is just pretty printing those values to the screen. And if we copy one of these IDs, we can navigate to its individual blog post and see the data just for that specific post. So our Next.js application is also super simple. It has a component for all of our posts, and then a component for each post individually. And this is using the brand new app directory in Next.js. So both of these components are server components by default. And so if you want to learn more about the app directory and fetching and caching data in async server components, I recommend you click that card above and watch our previous video where we go through exactly that. So to set up a real-time subscription, we need to use useEffect. And this comes in from React. And then this takes a callback function, which we want to run on mount. Now, if we save this file and go back to our application, we'll see that this failed to compile. And that's because we're importing a component that needs useEffect, but this only works in a client component and none of its parents are marked with useClient. Therefore, they are server components by default. That's actually a super clear error message, and it even gives us a suggestion for the next step that maybe one of these should be marked as a client entry with useClient. And so any component in the app directory is by default a server component. And so all that data fetching stuff happens on the server, and then our component is rendered on the server, and then that rendered version of the page is what gets sent back to the browser. Now, useEffect happens client-side, so once our application is actually running in the user's browser. And so the server can't do that because it doesn't have access to the user's browser. And so if we want to use these client-side hooks like useEffect, useState, any of those, we need to tell Next.js that we don't want to do any of that server stuff, just let this component be rendered by the browser. And so to do that, we just need to come up to the top of our file, and it's very important that this is the very first thing in the file. We just want to say use client in single quotes. Now when we save this file and go back to our application, that's saying objects are not valid children in React, and if you want to render a collection of children, use an array instead. And so it's saying we're trying to give it an object with a promise, and that doesn't make sense. And this is because client components can't be async components. Only server components can handle async stuff. And if we get rid of that async keyword, then you'll see now we can't await those results from Supabase, which means we'll need to wrap this in useEffect and then have an extra variable using useState for our posts. And then we'll also need to keep a track of our loading state and probably render out a loading spinner while we're doing all of that. Not very hip stuff in 2023. So let's undo all of that client component stuff and take it back to our async server component that's fetching our posts from Supabase. Now, what if we combine these two concepts, so server components and client components, and have our server component fetch those initial posts when the user first loads the page, and then have a client component that can subscribe to those real-time changes and update the UI dynamically. So let's start by creating a new component in this real-time folder, and this one can be called realtimeposts.tsx. And then we can export our default function for real-time posts. And then this is going to take in a prop for server posts. And then from our component, we just want to return our pre-tag, which is pretty printing out those server posts that we got as a prop. Now TypeScript isn't happy because it doesn't know what server posts are. And so we can actually generate our TypeScript definitions based on our Supabase schema. So check out the link in the description to learn how to do that. But for now, we're just going to specify this type and then say that our server posts are going to be a post array. And so we can now use this real-time post component instead of our server component being responsible for rendering out those posts. And this takes in a prop for server posts, which can be set to our data that we got back from Supabase here. And then we can close this component. And you'll see TypeScript is already helping us out by saying, well, data could be an array of anything, but it could also be null. And so we can say if data is null, then we want our server posts to be an empty array. So if we save this file and go back to our application, we should be seeing our posts again. So let's wire up our real-time updates. So in our real-time post component, again, we want to use useEffect. And so this comes in from React and takes a callback function, which we want to run on mount. And then because we're using a client-side hook, we need to use the useClient statement. So again, this needs to be at the top of our component, the first line in our component, use client. And then in our use effect, we can use our Supabase client, which is a helper function we set up in the previous video, but it's coming in from @utils/Supabase. And in that file, we're just calling create client from Supabase.js and passing it our Supabase URL and our Supabase anon key. So we can use that Supabase client to set up a channel. So we can call this anything we want. So I'm going to say Realtime posts, and then we want our channel to listen on Postgres_changes. And now the name of this one is important. This needs to be Postgres_changes. We can then pass it some options for our subscription. So the event that we want to listen to is insert. So this is anytime a new post is added. The schema that we want to listen to is public. So this will be the case most of the time. But if you know what Postgres schemas are, you can listen to changes in any schema. And the table that we want to listen to is posts. We now give Supabase a callback function, which it will call anytime a new post is inserted into the post table. And this will automatically be passed a payload, which will contain all of the information for that new post. And so for now, let's just console log out our payload so we can see what's in it. And then lastly, we want to call .subscribe. So this whole big chunk is going to give us back a channel. And so to clean up our subscription in use effect, we can return an arrow function. And then in here, call supabase.removeChannel and pass it our channel. And then because our use effect now has an external dependency on this Supabase client, let's add it to the dependency array. And now we can save our component and go back to our application and refresh. And we can see our two posts that are currently in our database. And now if we go and add a new post, so if we go to the table editor and then click posts and then insert a new row, and we can call this one server components and realtime and click save to insert that new row. And now if we go back to our application and open up the console, we'll see that nothing has been printed out. So what's going on here? Because in our code, we're console logging out the payload that we should get from Supabase. And this is because we haven't actually told Supabase that we care about those events. So if we go back to our Supabase dashboard and then under database and replication, we see Supabase realtime. So if we click over here where we have zero tables and then we enable this toggle for our post table, this tells Supabase to broadcast any of the changes on the post table. So now if we go back to our application and refresh, and then we go back to our table editor and click the post table and then insert a new row for test and click save. Now when we go back to our application, we'll see that this has logged out our payload. And in here we have some information about the event itself. So we can see that this was an insert event that's just happened. And then this new object is our entire row from the database. And so we want to take this new post and dynamically update our page to display it alongside our other posts. And so we're going to need a variable to keep a track of our changing posts. So we can say const posts and set posts are equal to calling useState, and that comes in from React. And then we're going to set the initial state for our posts to be those server posts that we got passed as a prop from our server component. And then in our use effect, rather than console logging out our payload, we want to call setPosts. We want to set this to a new array, spreading in our current posts, and then adding our new post from our payload. And this is TypeScript saying it doesn't know what payload.new is, so we can say that this is going to be a post. And now we have two new external dependencies, so posts and setPosts. So let's add those to the dependency array. And then rather than just rendering out our server posts, we want to render out our dynamic posts. So if we open these up side by side and then insert a new row for test 2, you'll see as soon as we click save, you'll see our new post appears without needing to refresh the page. And then we can follow a very similar pattern to listen to any changes on our individual post by going back to our application and creating a new component for our realtime dash post. And then we can paste in the same code that we had in our realtime posts component. And we just need to update all of the plurals to be singular. So basically anywhere it says posts, we want to be post. And since our post is a single value, we don't need to construct a new array. We just want to update its value to our new post. And then changing these last few mentions to be singular. And now the event that we want to subscribe to is no longer insert, because we don't care about new posts being added. We care about updates to this specific post that we're currently viewing. And then because we only want to listen to updates on this specific post, we can pass this a filter to say we only care about posts where the ID is equal to EQ dot and then our post dot ID. We can then use our real-time post component in our server component instead of rendering out this post directly, which comes in from dot slash real-time dash post, and then our server post prop is going to be set to post. So if we go back to our application and refresh for our test two post, if we were to go and edit this post and instead make it test three and click save, we'll see that post is automatically updated in our application without needing to refresh. And that's how easy it is to combine server and client components in the Next.js app directory to merge real-time events from Supabase with our initial server state. Now we're going to be doing a few of these server component videos, so if you've made it this far and you haven't done so yet, click that subscribe button and enable notifications to hear when the next one drops. Until then, keep building cool stuff.